the fucking move today, baby.
We got some big plans today.
Yeah, so we're gonna go to a fucking taco truck because, you know, we need some spice in our life.
Yeah.
Okay? And then after that, we're gonna go fucking train at Zoo with your boy Blaziken. And we hung out with him last night. How'd it feel, Reese? What'd you think?
It was crazy. My man made us some steaks.
The fucking game over house.
The game over house. Yeah. It was lit.
He made us some steaks. Very nice dude. He's super smart. Great words of wisdom to take after.
Yep.
You know, and he told me one thing. He's like, you know, D-Train, you're so primal. You're so straight to the point. Don't ever change. Don't ever change.
Take those words.
Yep. Sir.
Hazard reported ahead on
a lot of people in there?
Right now I'm kinda.
Alright. Yeah, we're just gonna tear it up. That's cool.
Like always. Is that gonna grab a picture real quick?
Yeah. No. What?
Nope.
No.
But I'm ready to get fucking juice.
Let's do it, baby.
What's going
on? I'm thinking we should hit some fucking chest.
Chest? Alright, yeah. I'm
maybe
down.
Chest and
shoulders? Yeah, I'm down. Yeah.
Alright, good shit.
Dude, my first time at Zoo Culture.
Really? Before we go in, what do you think it's gonna be like?
I think it's gonna be a dope gym. I mean, it's owned by Bradley Martin, right? And yeah. I always see like hella influencers here and shit. So I don't know, might catch an influencer in the wild or two.
Yeah, they're probably gonna know who you are than me.
It's cool that you can film in here because like a lot of gyms like don't let you film and shit.
So like Golds. Yeah, did exactly. I tell you that they told us we couldn't film, and then the worker came up to us and was like, you know, you can.
Mid section.
Exactly.
No, we gotta get nice and juice today so we can fucking hit the D turn.
Yeah, I gotta show you some poses.
Yeah.
So we're gonna go pin some Tran and then you know the fucking drill.
Start.
A long time.
Yeah, I don't really bench press him.
Sure, I gave him some Anadrol, so 315 should move pretty smooth. Time to get some fucking pumps going.
So I mean, I hit chest at least once a week, but I'll start off usually with like incline dumbbell press.
That's what I like.
And then I'll do like some sort of fly variation after that.
Yeah.
I'll hit maybe like a incline machine press. Yeah, dude. I just normally don't ever hit.
If you're not comfortable with it.
No, I'm super comfortable, bro.
We can do that incline right there.
No, let's do it, bro. I'm down.
Fucked up in poker, bro.
Yeah. Yeah, no, of course I remember, bro. Yeah.
If you guys didn't know, this is Kyle from TikTok. Yeah, he was asking me about like how Texas was, all that. It was fun.
It looked lit. Did you meet C-Bomb?
Nah. So how long have you been training here for?
I moved here August 2nd.
You know what's funny? The last time I came here, I met Ryan.
Yeah, I saw that.
And now I'm meeting you.
Yeah,
isn't that kind of funny?
I'm usually never here at this time. I'm always here late.
Oh, yeah.
I'm always here late. Today was my first off day in like a month. Like, literally, I've been doing weights, like, I don't know how bad it is. I'm not getting sore.
Yeah.
I don't know. Today was just a cardio day.
Yeah, you look like you're coming off a big pull.
Yeah.
Really big.
I'm like 220 right now.
Damn.
I'm freaking legs, and my legs are pretty lean.
Yeah. Big dude.
I hold on to all my last bit of fat in my low back, so. I'm just trying to get tight cut. Yeah. You're pretty lean, too.
Yeah, I'm all
right. What are you doing there right now?
245.
Holy shit.
Yeah. I don't feel 245. I feel like I'm 215.
Are you bulking or are you doing?
I'm just fucking doing nothing. Just staying. Kind of just, you know, just not trying to get fat, not trying to get too skinny. So, just chilling.
Yeah, I see your diet. Your diet's funny, bro.
Yeah, I eat whatever I want. I don't eat enough. So that's why I eat that. Yeah, I eat like 2 meals a day.
That's fine. Well, I'm about to head out, bro. I was going to
Yeah.
Well, you got me, right?
I got you.
You got him, right?
I'm in a safe place. If anything happens, I'm
going to
protect him.
I should have it. We'll
see. Yeah,
you got him, bro. Music are you guys in? What kind of music do you go for?
Dude, honestly, I pretty much like only bump Yeet at the gym. It's pretty
really Yeet's the current vibe. What do you feel? How do you feel about Yeet, D-Trend?
Tired of hearing it.
I used
that's
Yeet.
All I heard in Houston. Thank Sush for that. I would hear it probably a good 40 to 50 times a day. The same three songs.
For real?
It's crazy. Fun the first day, but then after like the fifth day, it's like a never ending dream.
Oh my god.
Peep my SoundCloud.
It's we have literally nothing but fucking Yeet songs, bro.
At least it's not the same Yeet.
Wait, hold on. Keep recording. It's not done yet.
Oh my goodness, man. Dude, he's got every. He's fucking sick. I fuck with his music too.
Oh, I said, fuck it, I'm with Blaze, so I was like, why not come to Zoo?
Yeah. Dude, it's so much, like, I was expecting it to be small, but it's like twice as small as I thought.
Is this the first time you guys have ever been here too?
We've been here since Wednesday.
Yeah.
Oh. So, shit. Yeah, we've been working out.
Where are you
here
from?
Charleston.
Oh,
nice. Yeah, across the country.
Oh,
yeah, it's
fun. Crazy.
Yeah. I'm from California, so, you know, near fucking San Francisco. So I'm like, why not?
Oh, nice.
Yeah. I just come out here and train and whatever the fuck.
Yeah, that's still a good bit, though.
Yeah.
Good luck with your workout.
All right,
nice meeting you, man.
Thanks, guys.
I'm gonna send the Liver King a video because he just asked he literally just said primal phase Liver King checking in how on his primal how is it going.
Check it, he's fucking texting Liver King.
Dude,
right
he just
now.
DM'd me this morning, bro.
Look at that, he just DM'd him paragraph.
He said he literally just like 10 minutes ago
he said
primal phase Liver King just checking in on his primal how's it going. I'm gonna send him a video, I'm gonna be like primal checking in here. We're at the gym right now currently with a primal D-Trend. Getting absolutely diced and shredded for the summer.
But hope you're doing well, Liver King. Very primal war.
Dude, if I ever hop on, it's gonna be
What would you run?
Dude, I mean, I don't know.
Like, what are you interested in? Which one
I'm,
really has
I'm super interested in just trying out testosterone. I'm not currently on anything right now. And to be completely honest, I probably won't be on anything for a while. I am super interested in hopping on test just because I want to see what it's like to have balanced test levels for a little while. Obviously, a lot of, you know, it's not something that you just do. It's like something that you carefully research. And, you know, if you do it incorrectly, you can really fuck yourself up. So I'm just saying that just because there's probably going to be a lot of young people watching this. And like, steroids ain't never nothing to fuck around with. D-Trend's very honest and open about his steroid usage, which I think is super dope. And you can learn a lot from it. I've learned a shit ton from him. Yep. But yeah, dude, it's definitely a super interesting world. If I was to actually run a cycle, it'd probably be something like oxandrolone, Anabar. 50 milligrams with like, shit, dude.
500 tests.
Yeah, 500 tests.
Would you throw some growth hormone in there too?
Yeah, I mean, I would if I can get some like good, a pharma grade growth hormone.
Oh, you can get some good shit.
Pick up the weight, Dietrich.
I was sweating after that set. Botting him, I was sweating.
I couldn't hear you talking shit?
No. I said I was sweating after that set. Botting you, I was sweating. Yeah, that was such an intense work. Like, dude's really pushing that shit.
Push it.
The thing is, people think that weight is all that matters. It doesn't. What matters is form, and if you're feeling it.
Oh, yeah.
He's pushing till failure every set, and that's how you grow. You don't, like, you see me, I'll take the 75 dumbbells. I don't need to go super crazy because I'm feeling the muscle. We're not powerlifters. We're bodybuilders. That's how you grow muscle. We're not trying to grow our tendons.
We'll be right back.
Okay, okay.
If someone isn't using it. There's tons of equipment here.
Let's get lucky.
Hey, people always say I look smaller on video. I don't know why, maybe. It's just how, that's just how shit is.
I thought you'd be a little bit shorter.
Yeah.
You are fucking you.
Every time I ask people, how tall do I look on video? They're like, 5'9", 5'10".
Oh, no.
Short king.
Dude. Nah. Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you too. If you want to get a picture. Hey, check it out. Check it out. Yeah, if you want a picture.
Oh, the young Trey.
50%. You know I got that from it.
He's rocking the.
Always.
Hell yeah. I'm not even really rocking that much. I'm rocking the jogger spot. Fuck it.
I just got those block shirts yesterday too.
Oh, good shit.
Fire.
Yeah. Fuck yeah, baby.
You want to get a picture?
Yeah. Shoulders are sore. Injecting right there. I pinned Blaze's ass before in the bathroom. I pinned a 5cc right in his ass.
Oh wow.
Test, Tran, and some Boldenone.
Fuck. 40 pounds
in
the next 3 months.
He's going for Mass Monster, so we're really gonna get his ass in gear or get gear in his ass.
For clarification, this motherfucker is capping, okay? I'm not
just for clarification, I'm not capping.
He's fucking capping.
Test rage in them. You really do. You got that, like, there's like normal Blaze and then there's fucking gym Blaze.
Yeah, my friends always tells me I'm very vocal when I lift. Like,
were you a rager playing games?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
I was a rager too. I've broken at least like 30 controllers in my lifetime. Like 30. I've broken a TV. I've broken a PS2. I ripped a fucking tray off. I've done so much shit when I was a kid.
Feel that.
Halfway through the workout right now?
Yeah, I think so.
How you guys feeling?
Yeah, pretty solid.
Pretty solid?
Pretty solid, yeah.
That's what's up.
I'm actually having a good workout. Last time wasn't nearly as good.
Yeah. A lot of people last time. Yeah,
it's tough when the gym's like packed as fuck. It's a little like chill right now.
So. Literally.
Yeah. Are super great. Like, I'm not trying to put it on Blaze, but if he did a podcast, that shit would blow the fuck up. Really? I don't know if he ever wants to or he'd ever think about it, but Crazy. It seems like it's a fucking thing. Let me know in the comments if you would watch Blaze's podcast if he helped.
Oh yeah, he's just saying what's up. How's it going?
What's up, brother? How's it going?
Can't hear you just because I have your buzzer.
Oh no, yeah. Good shit.
Say anything. If you are a fan of D-Tran and you want to see him out in LA, fucking hanging out with all the other dope ass people that are out here in LA, none of the fucking weirdos, just dope people. Tell him to fucking move out here right now. Leave a comment, say D-Tran moved to LA ASAP. We talked about it last night, and he really wants to, but you know, it's a big move. You know what I'm saying?
I have a question for you.
Okay, yeah.
You're the big time influencer.
That's what you think. I'm really not.
You are. Why not Houston? Why LA over Houston? Because everyone wants me to move to Houston.
Sure. So, definitely like specific sub communities of entertainment have like different hubs. So, for example, I know that like there's a fitness community that exists on social media, you know, whether it's YouTube, TikTok, whatever, and a portion of that community operates out of Houston. And I understand that. But bottom line, LA is where everybody goes who's a creative motherfucker who wants to make shit happen. Yeah. It doesn't matter if you're a musician, it doesn't matter if you're in the movie industry, TV, if you're YouTube, it doesn't matter. Everybody comes out here to come together and create shit. That's what's so powerful about LA. D-Tran pulls up here, gives me a fucking phone call, says, Blaze, you wanna pull up and let's make a video? Like, and I'm here, you know what I'm saying? He can't do that back home at his house. And he can only do that in Houston with a specific number of people. Yeah. But out here in LA is really where everybody's at. So everybody who wants to make it as a creative, I feel like should give LA at least a year. You know what I'm saying? There's no rush on it. You know, make sure you're good. But everybody should try. Everybody should come out here for this year and just fucking do it up.
Damn.
I agree. I feel like there's a little bit of a, you know, stigma with LA. Like, oh, it's not worth it. That's not the place to go anymore. But I believe the only reason why there's that stigma is because it's not easy to make it big out in LA. It's not easy. Yeah. So people always want the easy way out. They want to go somewhere and just blow up and collab with people and not have to, you know, make their own content. You know, they want the easy way. They want someone to just put them on. And LA is kind of like, you got to have something to offer for people to want to collab with you. You can't just be a guy with 10K followers signed by Gorilla Mind. That's not how it fucking works. So for the most part, I love LA. He knows that. We talked about it. You know that. So I'm pretty much fucking sold. I wouldn't see myself moving to Houston. It's just not my thing. California is where it's at.
California, all right? Baby.
There's everything here.
Everything.
So who knows? You might see D-Tran fucking LA. All right, so Blaze said that Bradley, you know, since we're at his gym, why not, you know, talk about it? He's on a heavy cycle, and I wanted to ask him, how does he know that? How does someone like Blaze, you know, an average dude, not in crazy into bodybuilding, how does he know that? How can you tell
he's on a crazy cycle? So I want to start off just by saying that I'm just making an assumption. I don't know for sure if he's on a cycle. I always like guessing because, like, I think it's an interesting thing. I don't think it's a bad thing at all. Like, I don't think it's something to be ashamed of. I understand that some people don't like talking about it due to like brand purposes. Like Gymshark, for example, and stuff, their athletes aren't allowed to talk about their gear usage because the brand is heavily against it. So I respect not wanting to talk about it for specific reasons, but I love just chatting about it. And personally, I think he is on another cycle. And I don't know for sure, but like, dude, he just, not too long ago, I seen him looking, not the best. And then this is a picture from like maybe like a week or two ago. He's looking fucking dice, bro. Looking fucking good. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Wow. I would say he's taking something to like maybe pull the water and does muscle a little bit more, like a Wii or
a Mastron.
Mastron, yeah.
Yeah. Maybe Primo Bowling.
Maybe.
I feel like he would like Primo Bowling.
Yeah. Maybe.
He kind of has that. Bradley has very full muscles, so you could tell he really likes testosterone. And he probably runs a high test, high Primo Bowling, because Primo Bowling has like little to no side effects. Like,
Which are the steroids that make you lose your hair? Because I know he's like prone to like...
Any of them. So like, you could lose your hair with any steroid. If you're, you know, predisposed to it.
Exactly, predisposed. That's what matters in that. If you're predisposed to the baldness, and take steroids. Like, it's gonna happen sooner than it would have if you didn't take steroids, but it's gonna happen regardless.
Yeah, but there is steroids that make that process happen faster.
100%.
Mainly DHT driven. So your Proviron, your Winstrol, your Anavar, maybe your Tren, Mastron, Primo, like stuff like that. You could lose your hair. So, but testosterone too. Testosterone's one of them as well.
Yeah, no, for sure. Yeah.
Thank you, brother.
All my friends are like fucking dumb as shit. And I call like, bro, when I'm 20, I'm gonna hop on fucking do some gear and shit. I'm like, you're dumb.
Yeah.
You're not gonna do like lifting for at least 2 to 3. Like,
you're not that guy, pal.
No, I
that's what you gotta tell him. You're not that
fucking guy. It's like, yeah, it's funny shit.
Alright, good shit, brother.
Okay, 1 out of 10. Give it a number.
I'm gonna give it a 10. Just because I'm with Blaze right now.
That's fucking, that's a fucking
That's
guy.
Why I'm that's giving it a there. 10, because this guy, out of anyone, hit me up and said, let me know when you're in LA before I even came here. He made sure that if I was in LA, you was gonna hang out with me. And that's what he fucking did.
Yeah, dude, I mean, I've been watching you. I feel like out of every big personality that exists that knows you and follows you, I was the first one to watch you on TikTok.
Mm-hmm.
And I was the first one to like reach out to you. And I'm like, dude, your personality's fucking lit. I'm fucking SKN. I'm in there like
Sikat Nation.
Yeah.
Why though? Like, why did you follow me? Like, for what reason?
Dude, because you.
There were so many other people you could choose.
I think I'm still like really trying to figure out like why I fuck with you, but I can tell you for sure that you really stand out amongst the general crowd of people who do what we do. You know what I'm saying? I could sit here, we could talk about it all fucking day. I really don't know for sure what it is. You just have that fucking energy. You have that no fucks given. Like, I'm gonna say what I feel, and I don't give a fuck if anybody has a different opinion, because this is, you know, this is me, this is my life. I say and do what I want, and like, I fuck with that, bro. We need more people like you in the world, you know what I'm saying? With that attitude and shit.
I really appreciate it.
Love.
Yeah, no.
So that's real fucking words right there. People probably don't think this collab, like, it's probably like one of the weirdest collabs, right? Like, a gamer and a bodybuilder. But fuck it, we made it happen.
Yeah,
and I'm glad I can motivate not just Blaze, but other people. There's other gamers, Dakotas, he follows me too.
Mm-hmm.
He likes my shit too. A lot of gamers, you know, I want to branch out, is basically what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
And I just don't want to stick to bodybuilders, because that's what a lot of bodybuilders do and they never grow.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe I could change that, you know, over time.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I already am.
I just want to say one final thought too. And this just goes back to like all the steroids and stuff that you talk about. I just want to say that even though like you talk about all that stuff, you motivate a lot of natties, like me, for example, to like get after it. You know what I'm saying? So all that bullshit aside, like where people are like, oh, you're spreading the wrong message or whatever. Like, if motherfuckers are doing stupid shit, it's on them. But bottom line, for a motherfucker like me, D-Tren has done nothing but inspire me. And yeah, dude, appreciate
That's
it.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That touched my heart. I'm starting
Hell
to blush.
Hell yeah, bro.
Nah,
that's lit.
Yeah, but I guess, you know, that sums up the fucking workout. Sums up pretty much our time in LA.
It does.
Perfect words said by Blaze.
Hell yeah, man.
And yeah, that's pretty much
Listen,
it.
To end off, I'm going to teach you how to do a phase up. So this is our fucking
phase up.
This is how the fans say phase up. You throw a pointer finger up like this, middle finger down, and then a thumb like that.
Middle finger.
So it's like these two.
I'm really
right
trying.
Here,
oh.
And then the thumb right here. Thumb straight, straighten the thumb out. There you go.
Oh, down.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, I
My
love
hands
it,
are
bro.
Too fucking thick.
For the thumbnail, baby.
No, you got it.
There you go.
Good shit. Why did you follow me? Like, for what reason?
Dude, because
there were so many other people you could choose.
I think I'm still like really trying to figure out like why I fuck with you, but I can tell you for sure that you really stand out amongst the general crowd of people who do what we do. You know what I'm saying? I could sit here, we could talk about it all fucking day. I really don't know for sure what it is. You just have that fucking energy. You have that no fucks given. Like, I'm gonna say what I feel, and I don't give a fuck if anybody has a different opinion, because this is, you know, this is me, this is my life. I say and do what I want, and like, I fuck with that, bro. We need more people like you in the world, you know what I'm saying? With attitude and shit.
I really appreciate it.
Love.
Yeah, no.
So that's real fucking words right there. People probably don't think this collab, like, it's probably like one of the weirdest collabs, right? Like, a gamer and a bodybuilder. But fuck it, we made it happen.
Yeah,
and I'm glad I can motivate not just Blaze, but other people. There's other gamers, Dakotas, he follows me too.
Mm-hmm.
He likes my shit too. A lot of gamers, you know, I want to branch out, is basically what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
And I just don't want to stick to bodybuilders, because that's what a lot of bodybuilders do and they never grow.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe I could change that, you know,
maybe
over time.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I already am.
I just want to say one final thought too. And this goes back to like all the steroids and stuff that you talk about. I just want to say that even though like you talk about all that stuff, you motivate a lot of natties, like me, for example, to like get after it. You know what I'm saying? So all that bullshit aside, like where people are like, oh, he's spreading the wrong message or whatever. Like if motherfuckers are doing stupid shit, it's on them. But bottom line, for a motherfucker like me, D-Tren has done nothing but inspire me. And yeah, dude. Appreciate
That's
it.
Awesome. Thank you. That touched my heart. I'm starting
hell
to
blush. Yeah, bro.
Nah, but I guess, you know, that sums up the fucking workout. Sums up pretty much our time in LA.
It does.
Perfect words said by Blaze.
Hell yeah, man.
And yeah, that's pretty much it.
To end off, I'm going to teach you how to do a phase up. So this is our
phase up.
This is how the fans say phase up. You throw a pointer finger up like this, middle finger down, and then a thumb like that. Middle finger. So it's like these two.
I'm really
right here,
trying. Oh.
And then the thumb right here. Thumb straight, straighten the thumb out. There you go.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, I love it, bro.
My hands are too fucking thick.
For the thumbnail, baby.